first pick here. And
Shenban. Calling it.
Shenban would be ideal.
Yeah.
Well, here's the thing. Shen or Nunu ban. Hmm. Whichever one you don't ban.
You take it.
You take them.
Yep.
You take them. And it's, they're both very big presences in the last game. You know, game number one, Shen just completely spiraled out of control top lane. And Nunu just
annoyed everybody.
He was so just running in circles. It's like, hey guys, look at me. I'm gonna, you know, it's like a kid like in the backseat of a car, like poking his little sister. But instead of poking little sister, he's poking Red Buff. It's like, hey, I'm not touching it. I'm not touching it. Look at me, I'm not touching it.
Yeah, and that's why I hate playing against Nunu, man, because you can't kill him.
Yeah.
And if you you get lazy or you just like forget about a timer or something like that, he'll come in and take your farm and then put you way behind. And
yeah,
I mean it's not such a big deal if you're like a gold pretend jungler and you're really hanging out in lane a lot. But Malphite, you know, requires so much of that ultimate that he in that downtime he farms a lot. And
yeah.
You can't farm if your jungle's stolen, so that's definitely a big issue.
There's a big requirement.
Yeah, I think
to jungles to have stuff to kill.
Yeah, exactly. So a Nunu ban wouldn't be surprising either, but I think this last one will be either Shen or Nunu, like you said. But my money's on Shen at this point.
Yeah, so we'll see. Blitzcrank.
Okay.
So they're going to force the Wolves to see if they want to, but here's the thing, the Wolves can just not ban either, and whichever one is not picked, they'll just grab it up here. Is that Ezreal Jace? So it's actually the same bans for the nerds.
Yeah, there's Shen right there. So
there you go.
Nunu wouldn't be surprising here. If they don't take Nunu, that'll leave the Wolves open to take Nunu and Sona again.
Rengar is now open.
Oh.
The Rengar ban was skipped in order to get that Shen ban.
Yeah.
So,
I don't know.
I don't think the nerds are even considering Rengar at this point. I think they're just seeing, oh, hey, Nunu's open. We should probably grab him.
Yeah.
And then the Wolves, they can grab that Rengar. They can throw him top. They can throw him in the jungle.
Yeah. Rengar is, in my opinion, a much more difficult champion to play than Shen. Mm. So, I mean, you have to kind of have a strong knowledge of the character. Shen, in my opinion, pretty straightforward.
Yeah.
So I think it's better to let them have Rengar rather than let them have Shen. So,
yeah. As long as if you have good team communication or good global map awareness,
yeah,
you're going to be good at Shen, period.
Yeah. And then Lee Sin. Okay, so Lee Sin. We don't see a lot of Lee Sin anymore.
Especially in that first pick.
Yeah, I mean, he was the jungle for a really long time, one of the strongest junglers, then really kind of, I guess, evolved and being like the top lane bruiser for a while. Voyboy really put him on the map at, I believe it was Kiev. So that was a significant time ago. But since then, since he's fallen off, he's not played a whole lot. Diamond Proc still plays him a good amount, but he's still very strong and, you know, has that mobility, can get in and out of fights and can trade really well. So I wouldn't be surprised to see him in top lane, you know, but of course he is an amazing jungler too.
I think nerds, their concern is that, you know, they want a little bit more of someone who can clear a little bit faster.
Mm-hmm.
Lee Sin does provide that just in case the Wolves do pick up Nunu once again.
Yeah.
But that's the thing is with Lee Sin is that if you fall behind, you fall behind.
Yeah.
Big time. Much, much more than a Malphite would fall behind. Because Malphite, at the very least, he doesn't require a whole lot of items.
Yeah.
Lee Sin, he really depends on, you know, farm and early kills and assists to get the items he needs to make sure that he has that presence going on in to the late game. But there will be the Corki and Sona stolen away from the Wolves, and the nerds will actually take him for a ride this time.
So, Nunu? I mean, I'm guessing we'd see a Nunu here. Lee Sin, I mean, suffers from similar problems that, you know, the rest of the junglers have. I mean, he can close the gap on Nunu, but once he's there, he can do a little bit of damage, and then eventually Nunu will kind of run away with that Blood Boil and that snowball. So it'll be interesting. But, I mean, in a time where we see, you know, it's kind of polarized in the way junglers are played, whether it's, you know, heavy ganking or the gold pretend jungling.
Mm-hmm.
Lee Sin kind of falls into that. He still uses, he's in the middle of that, and so he doesn't do as well. But here's Nunu. I mean, not surprised at all.
Here's Nunu.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Nunu. There he is, and he's just going to look at you, smile at you. So there is also the Leona pickup as well. So it's going to be a very aggressive bot lane to contend with the Wolves once again. Nunu, his presence in the jungle was amazing for the Wolves game number one. Mm-hmm. So now it's just a matter of what the Nerds are going to do. They still have their AP top and still they still need their AP mid and still not quite sure what's going to be happening with Lee Sin, whether he's going top or whether he's going into jungle. So Orianna going to be there once again. They could, the Nerds could try for the Morgana once again, but Anivia is also a pretty damn good choice.
Anivia is a really strong champion. Picking her last in that position, is good, and it's going to be interesting to see how she does against Orianna. Orianna's ultimate can do a little bit of work on Anivia, but that wall and the range from Anivia is always scary. So I think it's going to come down to it's really risky because of the ability for Nunu to invade and steal that blue buff, and Anivia is so reliant on that blue buff in the mid game. So if Nunu can do a good job of invading, controlling the space, he can get in there, steal that blue buff, and then put Anivia way behind. So I think that is going to be one of the main goals of Nunu this game. And then we saw Malphite being picked up as well. So Malphite ultimate into Nunu ultimate with Leona in there with all that damage, and the AoE on Wolves is scary at this point.
Yeah, Nerds had Malphite last time, but now that the Wolves have him in combo, lots of wombo combo potentials here for the Wolves. But you do have very good, strong top lane here for the Nerds. Anivia in the mid, always a wonder to see played, because that's a real testament on how good your AP mid is on your team. How well can they play Anivia? Yeah. Because it's a lot of skill shot oriented stuff, a lot of displacement stuff, and also a lot of very good mana management also, because that ult can eat up quite a bit.
Yeah, absolutely, and She's really good, but I mean, if you're not all that strong with her, she can actually work against you a lot with that wall. You can really just block off your own team and force things that you didn't necessarily want to happen.
Yeah.
players like Froggen, who are masters at using that wall, really can turn an entire game around into their favor. And Anivia also really popular for slowing the pace of the game down. And just really stalling the game until so you can get to the late game phase. And, Reddit Nerds, they have some really strong late game champions. You know, Aurelia is pretty strong late game. Corki, really strong late game. Anivia, late game is pretty beast too.
Yeah. But here is the one issue, though, that I see with the Nerds team, is they had a little bit of a problem game number one, defending the invade and defending against the steal on their own blue. Mm. And Anivia is a very mana-hungry mid. Same thing with Orianna. So, and there's the Nunu. The Nunu to contest with again. So, I can expect the Wolves to be very aggressive in the counter jungling once again.
Mm-hmm.
Try and just muscle out the buff control. And I also wouldn't be too surprised to see Sven actually all up in the Nerds jungle again at level 2, running in circles around Lee Sin.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, they're going to have a hard time there, definitely. And I think, actually, I like the Wolves bot lane again. Leona is just a really strong champion, and Sona relies so much on that poke, that early game poke, that if she's not careful, she can get caught out, and Leona's early game damage is one that actually surpasses Sona's damage.
Mm-hmm.
And so if Sona's not careful, the Graves-Leona combo can burst down champions extremely fast. And Sona, one of the issues is you don't have an escape. I mean, you rely on that flash and the slow from that E power cord, but other than that, you're in a lot of trouble, which is why Blitzcrank is also considered a counter for Sona in a lot of ways because of her lack of mobility. So the same reason, Leona can get in there and do a lot of damage, and it can be scary down there.
Looking for a little bit extra GP10s on the support here for the Wolves. Now we got Godbro this time. He's going to be running the Malphite, so he's looking. Just as the room page says, top sustain. He's looking for quite a bit of armor to deal with that Aurelia. What's his mastery? He's looking like 9-14-7. I like this.
Mm.
Get some mana regen. You get some health. Mana regen is so critical to have on Malphite, especially if you're top lane, because you run out very quickly.
Yeah, the name of that page, Mana Bruiser. So
Mana Bruiser.
So that's good. And that's exactly what he's going to do. I'm curious, I mean, because of Lee Sin's ability, of course he doesn't use mana. He can get in and out and use that energy that I mean I've seen Malphite go against champions with a lot of sustain getting Chalice, so you can do a lot of poke. So I wouldn't be totally surprised to see Chalice on Malphite for that poke and to try to counter out Lee Sin. Lee Sin. Against Aurelia, though. Again, similar situation. You're going to be able to trade well.
Right.
So Chalice wouldn't be terrible here.
Well,
but
what you could do is it's also not too uncommon to start. You know, stack up maybe one or two Doran's rings is pretty sufficient. Actually, that's what happened on Diana game one. Is like, you know, two Doran's rings.
Yeah.
That's usually enough mana to get by. In that situation, looking for a lot of harassment, looking to just desperately trade with the Shen, didn't quite work out. But in most instances, two rings are enough.
Yeah, absolutely. So that'll be interesting to see how Malphite plans on, you know, counteracting and trading well with Aurelia in this situation. So. Man, Nunu is such an annoying champion to play against, though. So
it feels like you're making your transition of like no fun Yorick is now turning into no fun Nunu.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I play a lot of jungle, and I think you do too.
Yeah.
And so, you know, the champions that really annoy me, I tend to ban out, like a Mumu and Nunu are two of those champions that really annoy me as a jungler. Because of, you know, their individual strengths. But, I mean, Wolves really utilized that strength last game with Nunu and hung out in the opponent's jungle a lot.
Yeah.
And I think we'll end up seeing similar things in this game.
On occasion, I mean, we do have a ranked 5 teams in the office.
Yeah.
You are our dedicated jungler.
Yeah.
And
I've actually been supporting lately, but yeah, I usually jungle. Yeah.
Officially on the roster, you're jungler.
Yeah, that's true.
And I'm top lane.
Yeah.
So, and how much Nunu have you actually played? Because that's the thing, too, because, like, man, that champ really annoys me. I should start playing that and annoy other people
absolutely.
As much as they've annoyed me.
Well, I mean, with any counter jungling champion, you have to have a lot of team coordination, which solo queue isn't famous for its team coordination.
No, it is not.
So, you know, not a whole lot of practice. I mean, the thing is about Nunu is, you know, whenever you get comfortable, he ends up coming in and taking everything, or he ends up, you know, catching you out, you know, out of place. So it's, I don't play him very much because it's similar to Yorick. I'm annoyed by the champion, and so I tend to ban him out rather than actually play them.
Well, it's, just recently, I mean, I'm trying to widen my range of top laners that I play. And I was talking with Baron on, you know, during a cast, and he said, you know, there's a special place in hell for people who play top lane Fizz.
Yeah.
So guess what I've been playing? Top lane Fizz.
Yeah, man.
So it is annoying, but sometimes when you actually pick up those champs, it's like, you know what? You start to get a little bit of appreciation towards him. That's also why I picked up a Lee Sin jungle a long time ago. He was like one of the first junglers outside of like the standard like Warwick and all of them that I actually picked up, and he's been working out pretty well. Wolves going for the invade here. Ward, nice ward placement from the nerds. Very good placement right there in the bush. We'll see the ward dropped over to the Tribrush, but this should be an inkling for the nerds to back off here. Kestrel and Jhin, they are in a bit of a dangerous position. You also got Niels right there on the side brush, but it looks like the nerds could go for a pinch. They have an idea where the wolves are. They could have they're pinging the brush by the red buff. They could have also retreated into the try. The orb from Orianna, I don't think she got the vision.
No, I don't think so. And I actually really like this out of the Wolves because this is one of the reasons Blue has such a strong advantage in the bot lane.
Oh,
caught that there.
Wolves,
so
they know.
Move in.
They could get something here. Kestrel being forced out. Jhin, at the very least, what the Wolves have done is they've forced the nerds to back, forcing the golems to reset. And with that, Jhin has taken too much damage from the engage. So actually, the golem camp is half done. So that's actually going to be putting Yells on Lee Sin at a bit of a disadvantage, and also clearing enough time for Sven to steal the red.
Ugh. Yeah. It was interesting that Reddit nerds decided to get blue with Lee Sin first instead of taking the red. I think they're really concerned about that invade. You know, that's usually, I mean, Lee Sin, you see, going right
nice.
For their opponent's red. I actually like that a lot.
But
so.
he is smiteless at the moment.
Yeah, he is. Lee Sin does have some strong early game clearing damage, so that should be good. And then this is actually going to set him up for a really nice gank on top lane if that's where he decides to go. So I was actually about to say that it's really popular for Lee Sin to get red, get his own red, and then do a level 2 gank on bot lane, especially with the strong gap closing. But we didn't see that from Lee Sin here, and he just looks like he's heading back to just do some more farming.
Yeah, and Yells left the one minion just to annoy Sven, just to get to see here. Sven's actually a little bit paranoid. He's searching around. He's like, oh, the red's gone. Where is this Lee Sin? Where has he gone off to? It's surprised he's actually already back at his own jungle, continuing the path. The only disadvantage to leaving the one minion behind in those camps is that, yes, you're gonna delay when that camp is gonna respawn, but you're not gonna know.
Yeah.
You sacrifice your timer to put the enemy jungler behind.
Yeah, what that really tells me is that Lee Sin is gonna be looking at doing a lot more ganking than counter jungling, even though, I mean, comes in, puts it in Nunu's face like, hey man, I can counter jungle too. I'm here too, I can do some things. So, I mean, going in and taking that, so pretty good.
Glucose pushing down Godro here in the top lane. A little bit, slightly more into the nerd's favor this time around. Aurelia actually nearly doubling up on it to Godro very early on. Bot lane, though, Kestrel's doing pretty well. Hunter's doing very well. Right behind the bot tower. Kestrel does get caught out with the sword from Leona. Quick stun, not going to be doing a whole lot. And Nails setting up here in the bot lane. As there are two wards left here on Winter. If he gets a little bit too far out, Nails could go for the engage. Quick on in, pull right on in. Winter a little bit too far out, did not know the Lee Sin was there in the bush. Could be a quick kill, first blood.
Nice.
Going to Kestrel there in the bot lane. Nice setup from Lee Sin. Bet you didn't think he was gonna be there.
Yeah, the beautiful thing there, of course, giving Corki the kill, so he has that advantage over Graves. You don't want to give Graves an advantage because, with his passive, he can actually get pretty tanky in the early game and can kind of will trade really hard, in his favor. So having a lead over Graves as Corki is going to give Corki, a lot more options in the lane and is going to allow him to farm a little bit better too.
Not to mention gold, about 500 up at this point. Yeah, Glucose with the surge over to the Nunu just to clear a little bit more distance and then flash on back to the tower. So good successful ganks, even if you don't get the kill. If you're burning those summoner spells like you saw earlier in the mid, you're doing a good job. You're doing your job as a jungler, you're making things a little bit better for your laner. And now Godro with that taking advantage, that's a huge wave he's looking to deny right by enemy tower. It's gonna be a lot lost for Glucose, and if he wants to pick up any of that, he's gonna be spending a lot of mana to surge on over to everything.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, really good for Malphite. And in the mid lane, we're seeing the problem that Anivia has with that mana consumption.
Yeah.
I mean, she's low. Orianna's like almost full.
She's empty.
So this, it's the ball is in Orianna's court, so to speak.
Basically, SUV hybrid.
Yeah.
That's pretty much what it is. Nicker hasn't gotten the credit card yet to go to the gas station to pick things up quite yet. And there's still going to be another good minute and a half until the blue actually pops back up there for the nerds. So now it's just a matter of, can you keep it controlled this time? And seeing as Sven is actually making his way down near the bottom side of the map, it seems that the nerds will have a safer time to pick up the blue this time around.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm curious to see if we're going to see Wolves get into position to try to deny the blue for Anivia. That would actually put Orianna really, really far ahead. We'll see how that goes. It's going to be...
Sven making his way on down through the Tribrush Dominion wave. We'll see if there's a little bit of time for the nerds to get back, but Snowda being chunked out huge. Not even with a whole lot of assistance, but you still get the snowball, you still get the assist. Valkyrie out from Corki. Urf letting out a shout as he does. And the Wolves picking up a quick kill there in the bot. Nunu going the long way around through the Tribrush.
Yeah, absolutely. And Leona getting the kill there, so not as good as it could have been. But still, killed nonetheless, and it's going to put bot lane in a better position to just push Corki out and get some good, easy farm. Oh, Malphite just taking a bunch of damage from Aurelia.
Just ate the entire ultimate.
Yeah, I mean, and Malphite really just needs to hang on so we can get out of this laning phase, because Aurelia is just going to really kind of push him around.
Aurelia's Ignite is still up, may just be enough. Flash out from Godbro, but the damage is too much.
Gosh.
The Ignite looks to get the kill, and a flash wasted from Godbro, and an Ignite. He actually used both, did not get the kill.
Ultimate flash and Ignite all used in a row
there,
so that's very unfortunate. I mean, one little inch further and Aurelia would have been under tower, and this would be a completely different top lane, but no, Aurelia got it. Looked like the last tick on that Ignite, and so Aurelia is going to be in a good position to shove Malphite out of the lane now.
Sven going on in for the Wraith Steel. He's got that warded. He's pretty solid. Nicker there with the blue buff. He secured that for himself. Wall down onto the Tess, followed up by the ult for a little bit extra damage. The Flash Frost will force out the flash from the Tess. Very well done. And nice presence from the Elstas staying there in the mid lane. But look at Nunu, though. Snacking on that red. And realizes he's got the ward still up by the Wraiths. Niels knows something is up, but pings are going down. He's like, hey, Nunu, he's coming down your way. Once again, snowball down onto Jhin. Sven also tanking the turret in the meantime. A little bit too much damage out on that one. But Niels cannot close the gap quick enough. He just cannot move down there in time. Because look at them move five boots on the Nunu. He's a very speedy Yeti.
Yeah, that was actually really good on Wolves. Good map awareness to know that Lee Sin was going to be coming down. It looks like he probably just tracked that ward a little bit and gave him vision into knowing to go back. So if I was in that position, I probably would have dove Sona and died. And so I mean, to be completely honest, so good on them to go back. Anivia has blue now. So they weren't able to take that away from her. And with that, Anivia is going to be able to farm extremely well and just really poke at Orianna.
Niels is looking for an attempted gank here on the top. He does have smite off. He can smite a minion, pop six, and then get the dragon kick. Look for some fancy footwork there. But he's looking for the slow. Wants a straight up damage onto Godros. Will be more than enough. Glucose with the damage. Getting that kill once again top lane.
Yeah, Aurelia looks like was taking just enough minion damage so she had less life. Oh, and Sona gets caught out.
The flash
is out.
Kestrel looking to follow up. Looking to get some revenge. Flying that engaged Jhin. Getting away with his life on that one. And very close to level 6. If he was 6, that would have been a very different story. But we're getting close, though. And he's got the drink in the health pot. Looking to stick this one out, stay in the bot lane.
Yeah. I was saying that Aurelia top took minion damage just enough to bring her life below Malphite so that her skill would stun instead of slow. Oh, and she gets caught out here. Oh, and Orianna goes down really quick.
To the face from Niels is going to be more than enough to take out the Orianna. The nerds are coming back on this one, man. I like it.
Yeah, really strong early start from the nerds. And, you know, that's just the strength of blue side right now. I think
it's just good. They're doing good. It's a K and a half up.
Yeah.
They're doing significantly better in their lanes than they were game one. You got a K lead on Aurelia there in the top lane. That's where the bulk of the gold is.
Mm-hmm.
Slight leads in the rest of the other lanes. You also got a little bit more money on Lee Sin than you do Nunu. But that's the thing, though. Hopefully the gold distribution will be a little bit more even over the next couple of minutes. Aurelia, if you can have a ridiculous amount of gold on her, she just becomes so much of a tank, you can just never really take her out. But
yeah,
you need to distribute a little more even. You need to get damage on Cork. You need to get damage onto Anivia.
Yeah. Glucose looks really comfortable on Aurelia versus Diana. I mean, Diana's a really strong champion, and that's why I feel like they probably picked her. Like, hey, she's strong. Let's just put her in the top lane. It'll be fine. But Aurelia, really strong in the top lane, does remarkably well in that mid game and does tons of damage, and with that mobility can really do a lot of interesting things. But here comes Nunu in the top lane. Let's see if they can get something done on Aurelia here.
Yeah, meanwhile, bot lane, you did have the wards in the brush actually catching up the Lee Sin, so that's going to be a gank deflected, but Glucose in a 2v1 situation here in the top, looking for the slows. You got Nunu, and you also got Malphite with that. The ultimate coming in on Hunter Tower, but the Ignite is back on up, and Godbro, with help from the Nunu, taking that one down.
Yeah, that's, the ward coverage was there, but it was so close to the actual lane. That's why you see the ward coverage in the top lane, usually brought out a little bit more, because by the time you saw Nunu has boots of mobility and the blood boil, it's already too late. He's already in your face, and you're going to get slowed and you're going to die. So the ward needs to be brought out just a little bit more to make sure that kind of thing doesn't happen.
Yeah, so, and especially when you have also stealth champs like Shaco, because when you get so low to the lane, you're not going to actually see him. So you need to ward out a little bit further than you usually would. But recognizing that two members of the Wolves are top lane and they did have to back, this is a good opportunity for the nerds to take Dragon, and they do. Smite from the Lee Sin will take care of that one. So it's extending the gold lead. Actually, not even. You're keeping the gold lead as it was before. The Tess being chucked out huge. Lee Sin got a little bit caught, but does manage to escape. Nunu not too far behind. Snowball on to the Corki. Does he have his Valkyrie up? He does, but the Leona ult gonna keep him behind. Will he be able to get out of the pit? No! Nice catch from the Wolves.
Very good play.
But that is still a kill for a kill. Dragon's worth about two kills. Mm-hmm. So an even trade there still gives the gold advantage to the nerds.
Yeah, absolutely. But actually, I mean, it's going to give Graves the ability to farm and push that bot lane, going to deny some experience, and it's going to give Graves that, you know, that experience advantage, which is really important. He's going to be doing more damage.
Sven's going in blind here, puts down the ward. It's not going to be there in time, but Lee Sin, can you get out of here? Nice kick backwards from Lee Sin. The Yeti just cannot connect to Snowball, and going to be meeting up with Glucose on his way back into the river, but the damage from Aurelia is going to be too... You can finish this.
I don't know, man. That Snowball, and not great map. I mean, didn't know where all the opponent's champions were, so yeah. Probably smart to get out. Might have been able to kill Nunu, but there would have been a cost.
There would have been.
Nunu has ultimate, so it could have been kind of scary for Aurelia there.
Yeah, I think Aurelia ult was up, so I think it could have been enough damage, but then again... When you have a lead like this,
yeah,
play it safe.
Play it safe. Yeah, I mean, it's not a huge lead. So Wolves is, you know, farming pretty well. They're farming better in most cases, and farm goes a long way. And you notice, I mean, they have a dragon, and they're up 2 kills, but they're only up 1.2k gold.
Yeah.
So it's not as good as it could be. However, they are in the lead, and they can continue to leverage that if they continue to play smart like they are.
Yeah, it's a very good also it's like a map territory battle too. You do have good control on the dragon by the by the nerds, but the wolves though they're warding significantly deeper into enemy territory as most of that to the credit of Sven on Nunu. So it's a very interesting push and pull battle we got going on here, and I think the warding may be the deciding factor here going as we start heading on into the mid game, because. You have all this vision, all this presence on enemy territory from the wolves and the nerds. They got nothing. They got Jack.
Yeah, it's Graves right here too. Just pushing that lane's gonna go down pretty quick, and that's actually gonna be a big issue for the Reddit nerds. They're gonna have to ward up really well. And here comes Lee Sin, maybe trying to make a play, but
he's getting
just hanging out. But the aggressiveness of Leona and Graves with that tower down is gonna be a real problem for Corki and Sona. Hopefully they can put something together. Hopefully they ward well, which they're actually not all that well worded right now. I mean, if you look at the Wolves' wards, really strong. I mean, they have a really good sense of where the opponent is. They're not going to get ganked in that bot lane, so they have good control of the map right now.
And when you know that you're not going to be ganked, when you already have that vision, what does it allow you to do? It allows you to push. It allows you to put damage on the tower. And while the gold has been even, bot lane tower and top lane tower are actually very weak for the nerds. So those are about to go down momentarily. Just a little bit of presence, a little bit of pressure, and those will both go down. And when those both go down, the gold is going to swing huge in favor for the Wolves. It's essentially going to negate the lead that they've had this entire game. There you go. You got the tier one and bot going down. You got pings actually going down onto the nerds red. So the Wolves going to be going for that invade for that steal. Top lane, you got
Godbro.
Why the hesitation? Glucose could have had that.
Oh my gosh. He could have had that one.
I could have hit you and killed you, but just walked backwards. Why?
Meanwhile, in the jungle down here, just Wolves just hanging out, trying to control some of the map here. And it looks like, did Nunu get the red on that? It looks like Nunu probably was able to smite the red out and take that. But this is all as a result of strong jungle awareness from Wolves. I mean, they had those really deep wards and were able to know where the opponent was. And then back at that top lane, Aurelia stuck around and actually is going to push into that tower. But if you look at Malphite, look at his tankiness. I mean, he has the ninja tabby and he has the shield and then the chain vest. So he's doing pretty good in terms of tankiness. So it's going to be a little bit harder for Aurelia to actually have the killing blow.
Yeah, Godbro looking for the Frozen Heart build. So he's going to be looking to finish that Shroud as soon as he can. And yeah, that bread buff was taken by the Nunu. He did get the refresh on it. And I'm still amazed. Glucose just did not get that kill. Just one stutter step, just one misstep kept him out of grabbing that. He could have taken a tower on that with all that time killed, but instead Godbro actually just hop back in lane. 1, 2, and 3, taking down top tier one. So now with the tier one in bot and top now gone, the Wolves have actually swung the gold back into their favor, and they've been behind for a good portion of the game already. But with this, they're a little bit more confident. They have immensely more map presence, and they're looking to swing it on in through the mid game.
Yeah, Nunu, what that Oracle's clearing those wards. The cool thing about Oracles, I mean, of course it lowers their vision, but it also, you'll know when your gank is going to be successful. If you don't run into a ward along the way, you're like, oh, okay, this is actually going to work. Let's make this happen. They have no idea I'm coming. So, it raises the successfulness of your ganks when you know that there's no wards there.
Yeah.
And it makes it so you're not wasting as much time. Like, if you go in and you see a ward, you're like, okay, I don't need to gank. I can just go back to farming and go to a different lane. And I can just kill this ward and come back later. But when you don't have that, of course, you're essentially gambling on the fact that your gank is going to work and you're going to miss out on some farm.
So or of course, you can always just take out the ward and go anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, I just took out the ward. They're totally not going to expect me to follow up on the gank after they've seen
That's
me.
True. A lot of mind games coming.
A lot of mind games coming out with that. But you also have Lee Sin picking up an Oracles for himself, also looking to clear out. So, but Lee Sin, a little bit more of a Devil May Care champion. I think he's a little bit more at risk of losing it if he doesn't get his mobility on, if he gets hard CC'd. Like, he is there, forcing out the flash, and so much of just an orb of death coming in from the wolves. That happened way too quick.
Oh my god!
Really, anything? Wow, Nicker, will he actually get out of the revive? No, we're going bad because that was a lot that happened in like 3 seconds.
Yeah, there was a lot of damage there. That's definitely for sure. And I mean, Nunu went into ultimate and everyone was already dead.
So you forced the nerds back into this pigeonhole here, onto the ramp. You got nice, wow.
Oh my gosh.
Even in half speed, just the Orianna ult. This is so much damage to contend with. Nice notion on Lee Sin to actually flash out knowing, you know, winter is coming, but still, though, everyone is just left behind, and it doesn't matter how well farmed your Aurelia is. When you get caught in a rough situation like that, where it's just free damage for the enemy team, there's not much to do.
Yeah, that was a lot of AoE coming out of wolves there. I mean, with Graves ultimate, Malphite ultimate, Orianna ultimate, Leona ultimate, so, and then Nunu ultimate. So there's that was all. I mean, little hope for nerds when you're clumped up like that in a bottleneck and you're trying to get out and you're trying to run away, but you can't run because it's the Orianna ultimate. It's the Malphite ultimate. They're going to keep you in place and they're going to make your day horrible.
It's team you can't leave.
Yeah,
that's what
exactly.
It is. You can't leave.
And they didn't.
And they didn't.
Well, they did leave, but it was back to Nexus back to base because they were dead.
Right,
it was
rather
unfortunate.
However, I mean, best case scenario, though, despite those quick four kills, despite an amazing fight initiation that Wolves had, if you had to choose one person to live, you picked the right one. You picked Lee Sin, because losing that Oracles, now, especially more important now than ever, is it vital to keep onto that Oracles and make sure that Lee Sin lives, so you still have some presence here. That was a risky take.
Yeah, that was.
That was a very risky take on that ward. The very minimal vision, and Leona could have just gotten that stun. I had no idea how many more members of the Wolves were actually behind and beyond those wraiths.
Yeah, I looked down to Lee Sin's items. I'm like, oh, no, he probably has a ward. He could have gotten away. No, he doesn't.
He's got the wriggles, though. I bet it's still, it's still quite a while. It's a 3-minute cooldown as long as the ward is there.
Yeah.
But if you're going to be doing something risky like that, you got to know that thing's up or have a secondary ward in backup.
Yeah, absolutely. And yeah, like you said, losing that Oracles can be terrible because what you can expect right now from Wolves is they're ahead, so they're going to ward deep. Just like
they've been doing this entire game.
He just walked over two wards. So
but why?
Call. I'm not sure.
Yeah,
so he really needs to get those wards. But the key thing is Wolves can ward deep and then control the map and control the buffs and take objectives like you do when you're in the lead. And you need that Oracles to stop that map awareness. But, I mean, they have it, but apparently not using it the way. And that's actually one of the benefits of kind of attack moving around the screen is that you can actually, you'll auto attack the wards as you run into them, and you far less chance of missing them in that case.
Yeah, so shift right click or A and left click is the attack move. So if you do have an Oracles, if you're on support, attack move is not just for AD carries.
That's true.
If you're a support, or if you're support with an Oracles, or jungler with Oracles, or just have Oracles, just do it right through the bush just so you can take it out with the quickness and not kill any time. Going back, it's like, oh man, there was a ward in that bush. I should probably go back. Or if you're not paying attention, like Niels may have been.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's totally understandable. You're working, you have vision, like, okay, we need to go protect the blue, or they're going to dragon, so I just need to get there to make it happen. And you walk over those oracles, and we're not taking them out. You're giving a huge advantage to the opposing team. So hopefully, A move is the key to this situation.
A move, shift click.
Strongly increase your ward clearing abilities.
And or you're attacking someone into bush abilities.
Yeah, that's
too,
also true.
If you are in pursuit.
Yeah.
Yeah, learning a little bit here on the IPL LOL stream. A move.
A move, bro.
It's a good thing. This message brought to you by the Nick Allian Association.
Yes, exactly. It's a terrible association.
It's a terrible association, but we love it anyway.
Yeah.
Sven Kern getting caught out there, inconvenienced by the wall, but still ridiculously healthy. And Wolves, with all the pressure, looking to take out the tier two there in bot. You also got Godbro there in the mid, pushing around the Lee Sin just a little bit. Tier two will fall. The Wolves continuing on with the push. Not all the damage that Orb does is just silly at this point.
Yeah, they're doing a lot of damage, and I mean, you can also see the low levels coming out of Leona and Nunu. Just goes to show how much they've been roaming around and just making plays in general. Nunu 007, Leona 1-1-5, so they're making things happening for their team. And they're a little bit low, but the thing about them is they're so much about utility at this point that, oh, like that,
Leona,
closing in
nice
on Anivia.
Over the wall, getting the stun down. Nice ult from Sona, too, to keep everyone this way, but Malphite ult on the back line. The nerds are split, and there's more than enough time for the Wolves to actually get on in and get all the damage they need. You have two isolated members in the back line. Triple kill for the Graves, continuing on in for this push. And if your team is split like that, you've got a great ult like Malphite's, and it's a done deal. And Niels just has nowhere to go off of this. The smokescreen almost, the ignite. No, he does get the base.
Oh,
there
man.
There was no ignite. He didn't even use it. I thought, if Hunter's got the kill on the smokescreen, that would have been amazing and nice math on his end.
Yeah, no, that Lee Sin shield came in at the last second and was able to save him, which is really important at this point, that Lee Sin stays alive to at least help clear waves, hold onto that oracles, and not get too far behind.
Yes.
Wolves now is in a very dominant position. Their goal lead is now 7K. I can do math. That looks like 7. Yes, 7K.
Yes, math.
Math is good. They have really strong late game team with all of that AoE damage. As you approach that team fight phase and you're out of the lane, the AoE is going to be amazingly strong. And we've seen how Malphite's ultimate and Orianna's ultimate specifically have been really just turning this game around.
Yeah, it's one of the best initiation combos in the meta right now.
Yeah.
And when you have it, you see teams just melt and fall under the pressure. But the nerds are very aggressively going for this Baron. This is a last-ditch effort on their part. They know they're at a very big disadvantage. And there's the combo. Malphite with the ult on in, followed up by the Oriole. You kick him out of the pit. Lee Sin still taking Baron damage. Will he be able to live through that? I'm not so sure, but the test gravity kill on to Aurelia. Sven looking to get away from the Corki on the Earth. Meanwhile, in bot lane, Hunter's taking out the towers and the inhib, pushing it while the rest of his team is causing as much of a distraction as possible. But he's very low on mana. Can he actually take out the inhib with this pressure coming on
nice.
In? He got the slow coming from Lee Sin, but Hunter's dashing, ducking, and weaving, looking for the attack speed. He does have a pretty good amount of sustain on a 2, but when it's a 2v1, there's not much to be said, but Lee Sin waiting for his opportunity, waiting for the kill. You got the slow on him also. Can he make it happen?
Oh,
there's
man.
A shutdown, finally. Once he got the top lane, though, the Wolves still aggressing elsewhere on the map, though. While you have two members in the back in the base trying to deal with one champ, you're still outnumbered in the rest of the map, and the Wolves taking the advantage of that. Taking out the top tier 2, tier 3 going to be falling, and that is the surrender.
Oh, man.
GG game set going to the Copenhagen Wolves.
I was about to standing ovation Graves there if he managed to kill both. I was going to take the headset off and just like
get the clapping hands ready.
Yeah, exactly. It's going to be amazing. But good mobility. Wolves, Copenhagen Wolves, taking it 2-0 against Reddit nerds. Very impressive stuff out of
there. Very
them.
Impressive. And you said a little bit earlier about these Wolves.
Dem Wolves.
Yeah. There's a bit of rumblings beating some top tier teams. And you know what? The skill is definitely there.
Yeah.
And not to say that the nerds did a pretty damn good job. Game number 2, they had a very good lead. But the pressure, The push was just a bit too much to deal with, though.
Yeah, and they farmed remarkably well. Even though they were behind, they still continued to farm well, and it made it so their lead was very small. Reddit Nerds' lead was very small. So good good farming from them. And, of course, good farming is an implication of a strong team.
Yes,
farming
absolutely.
Is such a key part of the mechanics of this game. So farming well is a really, important part to be successful, and it looks like Copenhagen Wolves has that.
So with that, the Wolves, who's going to be their next opponent? They're going up next in round 16 against Eclipsia.
Yeah, Eclipsia did really well in our last tournament. They beat Curse EU.
They did.
Of course, Curse EU isn't looking the strongest right now. I think they might have some things happen to them. I'm not totally sure. But yeah, they took him out 2-0. So Eclipsia is strong, but Copenhagen Wolves also quite strong.
By the way, we still have a lot of other very top-tier teams remaining. Signing up for the last qualifier against All Authority, Acer EU. You got the Eclipsia, as we mentioned before. Meet Your Makers now in here. Alternate in here. Fnatic is back. SK is back. We'll see if they make it to round of four, then forfeit. And then...
Too soon.
And then you also got the NA side looking very strong. What do we got for NA tonight?
We have the Last Stand of Jarvan. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
All right.
Reddit
Last Stand of Jarvan.
Reddit team for the EU and Reddit team for the NA.
Yeah, Last
like
Stand
it.
Of Jarvan is one of our in-house favorite teams. They, they don't win, really, but they continue to get better, and we like supporting them. They're really awesome. And they're going to be playing against Team Normal Stars. I have no idea who that is. But
we're going
to
find out.
Similar to Copenhagen Wolves, I hear they're pretty strong. So we will see tonight how Team Normal Stars does against in-house favorite Last Stand of Jarvan.
IPL5 NA qualifier number 4. We started off EU this morning. We'll start off NA in about 4.5 hours. So be sure you are back for that. We should be done with qualifier 4 and should know pretty much nearly all of our teams by next Friday. So the list is starting to... The list is starting to complete. We're going to be knowing very soon the entire roster. And, of course, last qualifier, we had Elo Blade and Meat Playground joining us. They're going to be at the live show also. And, again, IGN.com/IPL5 if you want to go to the big show. Get your tickets now. They're the cheapest now that they're ever going to be. See you guys in a few hours for NA. Later.
See ya.